how I say one love. That's how I say one love. This section say one love. Everybody say one love.
The whole production, like a lot of my creative processes, began with research. You want to base a lot of creativity on fact. And so when I started looking deeper into the issue, a broader societal issue, the historic nature of the epidemic, as I would call it, and how it keeps repeating itself, it led me down a path to say, let's give them some real world perspective.
And time is the titan of humility. Your arrogance paralysis. You're fighting for futility. You feeling me? You feeling me? You feeling me? You feeling me? You feeling me?
Broken mirrors speaks to a negative self-image. So when you break that mirror, it forces you to go internal. It forces you to start loving yourself from the inside out because there's no vanity. It's shattering this myth of what is important. Bullies and bystanders, you can't have one without the other.
You look at the social impact that is happening in particular youth and how they're socially handicapped. We need programs that are unique and that are different and transparent.
The whole thing about looking at yourself inside out, because I used to have low self-esteem, but now if you see me, you would be able to tell.
We deal with all types of things that people deal with and oftentimes don't have an outlet to discuss.
Chance to give kids, you know, knowledge on how not to be a bully, not to be a bystander. If something's going wrong, it's okay to go get somebody.
I saw it open my eyes. Instead of being a bystander, you can try to help or you can go get somebody to help out. It taught me to be a leader, be myself, and don't care what nobody has to think about me. Just be strong.
These students have a million distractions, so you've got to keep their attention. That's why you see multimedia elements, interpretive dance, and then personal testimonies that are compelling.
Just to reach out and reach out to kids, not just kids, but people in general that are dealing with the issues that we talk about during this production.
I had a monologue that helped me reflect on some of the bullying I went through, and we're sharing our personal experiences through our art. Hopefully we're helping the children.
It was impactful, reinforcing that into my mind that you gotta be your own person, you gotta do what you wanna do, and you can't let people tell you what you can't do.
There's a greater sense of humanity when you see somebody up there expressing themselves through an instrument. Remind us that this music we're hearing comes from someplace, and use music as therapy, which is therapy for all of us as musicians, and go out on a positive note, go out on an uplifting note.
It inspires me to help others from bullying because too many lives are being taken and it's not fair to the community. People need to step forward. I think you guys should be all around every school and influencing everybody. Yeah.
It impacts students on an emotional and an intellectual level. We've all been either a bully or a bystander, sometimes both. And so when we show the emotional consequences of that for the victim and for the person who's bullying, it resonates with the students. It's a voice for the voiceless, and it's encouragement to people who didn't have the bravery to speak up or ask for help. We acknowledge the struggle, but we also highlight the triumph. The triumph of the human spirit.
Broken mirrors. Down, 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 down. I know you hear us.
Down, 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 down.
Broken mirrors.
Down, 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 down.
Yeah.
Broken, down.
Broken mirrors. Broken mirrors. I know you hear us.